Hey everybody, Nathan Brown, event director for FCP Euro here, coming to you from a buddy of mine's driveway. And today I'm going to show you how to replace the low pressure fuel pump control module, and fuel filter on a Mk5 GTI. So I was out driving and it was a little bit warmer day than it has been lately, about 85 degrees ambient. And I'd been driving for a while, about 2 hours. So the car had been running for a good bit and I started to get a loss of power. So no check engine lights, it would just kind of turn on, turn off. I actually drove about an hour home with the issue kind of persisting, and it made it without any issues. Again, no check engine light. So once I finally scanned the codes, I did have a couple codes in the ECU. The two codes that I had were a P2293 and a P310B. The first one, the 2293, is a fuel pressure regulator mechanical malfunction code, and the second one is a fuel pressure below specification code. So because I don't know if it was the fuel pump module that was going bad, the fuel pump itself that was going bad, or the fuel filter slash fuel pressure regulator that's going bad, I'm going to replace all three at the same time to cover my bases, and that should take care of everything. So it's worth noting there's two different fuel pumps on the car. There's a high pressure and a low pressure. The low pressure is in the tank, the high pressure is under the hood. If it was a fault with the high pressure pump, I would more than likely get some kind of a code for that. There's also a couple of sensors that could potentially go bad. Again, when those sensors go bad, you're going to get codes related to that, or codes related to high pressure faults, which I did not have. And I know for a fact that the pump is in good condition, and the fuel pump follower is fresh and everything like that. The cam is okay. So on the FSI cars, you do have to be aware of that. I know we've got some DIYs on replacing the high pressure fuel pump cam follower. So you want to make sure you've got that stuff covered as well. So if you don't know the condition of your high pressure fuel pump or the cam follower, you definitely need to check that as part of this process to make sure that's not faulty or not potentially bad as well. So these are the parts that we're going to be using today. I've got a VDO low pressure fuel pump. I've got a MAN fuel filter slash fuel pressure regulator, a genuine Volkswagen fuel pump control module, and I've got a fuel pump seal. So now we have our fuel pump. This is a low pressure fuel pump. You'll see there's basically two connections to be made plus an electrical connection. There's a third little nipple here that's not used for anything. You'll see all inside you have the various wires for the pump itself that go to that connector. The control module, the fuel pump control module, is what connects there to make this work. This right here is your fuel level float. So you have a little potentiometer right there. So as your gas gauge goes up and down, this float is actually going up and down. This is super crucial. You don't want to bend this putting it in, because if you do that, it is going to be a problem. All right, going over here to the fuel filter. So the MAN, like I said, is an OE supplier, two Volkswagen Audi. There are three connections on this. You'll note that it is stamped on the fuel filter, 6.6 bar. The original factory spec is 6.4. They all come as 6.6. That's like the most up-to-date version. The entire time that I've worked on these cars, sold parts on these cars, worked in the Volkswagen aftermarket, they've always come as 6.6. So like I said, MAN is an OE supplier, or is the OE supplier for most of the filters on Volkswagen Audi. Because this is such a crucial part, you want to make sure you use a really good quality fuel filter. The fuel pressure regulator being inside of here does mean it is a has pretty direct effect on your car's ability to make power, run efficiently and smoothly, and things like that. So you do not want to cheap out on these. So the fuel pump control module itself, this is a factory part. Again, we're using a factory part because it's a pretty crucial component. It does get hot. It does have electricity running through it. It controls the actual fuel pump itself. And you do not want to have a cheap unit here causing issues for you. You'll see the unit itself has a little box with a heat sink and a connector on it. And then you have the connector that actually goes down to the fuel pump. These are all kind of sized to only go one way, so you can't really, you know, mess up the way that it goes on to the setup. So we have our in-tank fuel pump seal right here. This is something that's super simple, super easy to replace. Basically just, you know, works to help seal this. It goes underneath, I believe. So it just works to help seal this as it goes into the tank. These, when they're exposed to gasoline vapor, they can actually shrink and get a little bit weird and a little bit funky. They're really, really difficult to reuse, and a lot of times you can't reuse them. And it's a pretty crucial sealing point. You don't want gasoline vapors coming inside of the car. So the tools that we're going to be using today are pretty basic. You really don't need a whole lot. The in-tank fuel pump can be done from completely inside of the vehicle. You don't need to go underneath of it. And all you really need are a hammer or a mallet, a large flat-headed screwdriver, and then a small flat-headed screwdriver or needle-nose pliers, depending upon how easy it is to get the connectors off the fuel pump. Underneath of the car, in order to do the fuel filter, you're going to need a Phillips head screwdriver, and again, a needle-nose pliers or a flathead screwdriver to disconnect those lines. You're also going to need a floor jack, jack stands, and some method of removing the wheel. I'm going to be using a half-inch drive impact gun with a deep protected wheel, you know, a specialized wheel socket. So the last thing that you're going to need is a 10 millimeter wrench or ratchet with a socket in order to disconnect the battery. So you don't want to do any work on the vehicle, on the fuel system, with the battery attached. You don't want anything accidentally grounding out or causing a spark or a fire hazard. Okay, so the first thing you want to do before you work on the fuel system or anything else in this car is disconnect the battery. This one has the hard cover on it. If you're doing this on a newer car, like a Mark 7 or some of the Mark 6s, it's going to have a little battery blanket that goes over top of it. So if you're positive and you're negative, I'd recommend disconnecting the negative. It's a 10 millimeter, so you just want to take that. Just loosen it up and then pull it right off. Okay, so now I have climbed inside of the vehicle. Ordinarily, there is a back seat here. You'll note that there are these little clips in the front. There's a couple of those. So the seat basically clips into those and then has at the rear these little plastic covers which kind of latch into that. So the back half of the back seat actually kind of clips into this. Via those little plastic clips. So what you basically do is pop the front up and then you can kind of rotate it, the seat up, and those clips rotate up and then slide forward, and then you kind of pop them out. So that's super easy to do. Once you have the seat out, you basically just lift up this carpet, and this gives you access here to your fuel pump control module and this cover right here. So just take a small flathead. This is super easy. You just kind of pop it to the side there, take that out. So here we have our fuel pump control module, and then this seal right here. So this is our cover here, and the fuel pump's right underneath. So this literally just clips in. So you just sort of just pop it out. It does have a little rubber gasket on it. So you can see there's lots of dirt, lots of debris on top of this thing. So I'm gonna vacuum that stuff out. I'm gonna grab a vacuum to take care of that. So before we vacuum this out, we're gonna go ahead and disconnect the fuel pump in terms of the electrics. We're gonna leave the hoses connected. So basically, we just wanna get the module out. So there's this little red clip. Once you pop that up, you basically put the pressure on that same clip, on the red clip, and to pop it out. So once you pop it out, you'll hear that release and it'll come off. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to vacuum that crud out. Then we're going to take our mallet and our hammer. And what you want to do is, again, you want to drive the locking ring ready, tighty, lefty, loosey. So you want to bang it to the left. So basically you want to put your screwdriver on one of those nubs right there. So now we're going to disconnect these hoses. Now these are really, really tricky to get off sometimes. There's a little button that, I don't know if you can see it under there, but there's a little button that has to be basically pressed in order to release this. So now our fuel pump lines can get tucked out of the way. The ring can come out. Set that to the side. And it's always important to take note of where your connections are. There's really only a couple ways these can go. But it's worth noting that, you know, this blue line here on the left goes there, and the black line goes there. So I'm going to try to get the fuel pump out of there. It is a little bit tricky because of the level sender. So this is how it's oriented. The fuel float is on this side, so I'm just trying to get this thing out without causing too much of a spill. There we go. So you can see there's actually a good amount of fuel that sits down in this. Now we've got the fuel pump out. You can see this thing is super old, super crusty. So we've got our fuel pump out of the way. We've got the old seal that sits in here. You want to note the orientation to make sure you put it the right way in. So the fat lip, or the fat seal part, actually goes on the top half there. So that, and we are just going to throw that in our little container there. Boom. So this is inside the fuel tank. So you can see there's actually some dirt and debris down in there, probably actually from the process of removing the fuel pump. So that's why you want to vacuum that up as much as possible. You can see why you would not want a lot of fuel in the car for doing this process, because if this was full of fuel, as you're pulling that pump out, you'd be pulling fuel out and it would cause a real, real issue. So we're going to go ahead and take our new seal. All right, so we've got the new seal in there. And now we're going to take the video pump that we have right back here, put that in. Now, as I said, it can only really go in one way, but you want to make sure you put it in the right way. So the way that it's oriented is kind of like this from the factory with the float like that. So basically you want to get a nice angle on it, get the float down in there, and then rotate and slide it right in. And that's our hose. When this goes in, this is kind of on a spring, so you kind of have to position it and put the ring on at the same time. You basically want to make sure it stays in place. You can see it's lined up where that little notch is, like that, and it fits perfectly, so you know we're in the right spot. And then you've got to get the locking ring back into place and ready to go. So we've got our two little protective caps here that we're going to pull off. That just pops off like that. And then we have our two fuel connections. So the black one went on the right. And basically just press it down. And it clips in place. And that's it. And then the blue one here on the left. And again, clips it down in place. Good to go. So now we can turn our attention to this old fuel pump control module and get that swapped out. So the fuel pump control module is super simple, just a little electrical connector there. So swap that out. Sitting here side by side, you can see there's a pretty big difference between the two. You have the new one that has the actual heat sink on it and the old one that does not. So we are going to connect our new control module. Make sure that's in there nice and tight, clipped in. It is. You have your cover here, and then that goes down through. We have our new connector. So that just goes down on, it clips in, and you gotta remember to clip the lock back in so that doesn't vibrate off, and we are good to go. So now that is connected. We have both of our fuel lines connected. We have our locking ring in place. We have our new fuel pump control module there where we need it to be. So from there, this cover can only go on one way. So basically all you have to do is orient that correctly with the shape of the car. And it kind of has little kind of pins that almost lock it in place. That way, you just, all you have to do is press it down. The fuel pump control module itself, the heat sink goes up. You see it's got this little ridge sort of where that goes. So that's that. And then you have your connector that actually goes in, or your wire rather, that goes in. And the seals, nice and tight. And we're gonna go ahead and get underneath of the car to replace the fuel filter. The first thing I'm gonna do is, we've got our actual fuel lines. Actually take these off. Ah, there we go. One, whoop. So blue in the middle, black on the left. There we go. Two down. I mean, one to go. So this last one is super tricky. It's a little different than the other two ones that we have. I basically just had to rotate this fuel pump around so that it would, that I could gain access to the push pin on top. If I remember correctly, I replaced this because the original one screw was so rusty, so that's why it's a Torx and not a Phillips. So yours would probably be a Phillips in this location. So now we've got our old fuel filter out. That was a Hanks that was in there. 6.6 bar, but we're gonna put the man in there because the man is the new freshy fresh. So we're back into the car. We've got our all of our lines, of course, disconnected. Our fuel filter goes in this housing here, and this is the little tab that was kind of giving me a little bit of trouble, because that actually helps to locate the pump in terms of, you know, keeping it in place so it doesn't rotate, and it also kind of keeps it held in otherwise. We have removed the caps from our fuel filter and we're going to put it in pretty much right like that. You can see the little locating tab there. It's pretty simple. Just gotta scoot those things out of the way. Slide it in. And boom, that's all you gotta do. So now I'm gonna go ahead and put my screw back in there to hold it in place. And the really nice thing about these types of fuel connections, they can be a little bit of a pain to disconnect from time to time, but they're really easy to put back on. This takes all the guesswork out of it. So that blue one was in the middle there. Clip. And then we've got our black one right there. It goes on and clip. And then we've got our output. Boom. So we're all clipped in. Everything's nice and tight. I usually just give them a little tug just to make sure that they're not going to come off. I mean, you pretty much know they're not going to when you hear them clip in, but that's that. So we're going to go ahead. We're going to throw the wheel back on, and we are going to prime, you know, get, you know, reconnect the battery, and then we're going to have to prime the fuel filter to get it to run. It'll probably take a little bit, actually, because it's a brand new filter and a brand new pump. Now we have our car ready to go. It's back together. It is in neutral. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cycle the key a few times to prime the pump. And now we're going to try and start it. Boom. Just like that. One thing that's important to note, because we had the battery out, you will get the steering angle sensor light and traction control light because the battery has been disconnected. Once you drive the car forward for a few hundred feet, then those will all go out and it'll be good to go. So hopefully you found this video informative and helpful. If you have any questions, always hit us up in the comments below. If there's anything that you would like us to show you or anything you'd like to see, then once again, drop it in the comments below. Hit like, hit subscribe for similar content like this, and we'll see you next time.